Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going on a field trip and we're going to Louisville, Kentucky. And we have reservations for this evening for dinner at the Brown Hotel. And our reason for choosing that particular place is that I have done a famous sandwich for you already called the Hot Brown. And it was created at the Brown Hotel. And I'd like for you to see an actual hot brown, and that's what I plan to order, one of us at least, my husband or me. If other things look better, then you'll have to stick with the hot brown I gave you, but hopefully I can show you something of the history of that sandwich and some other foods also. We're here in Louisville, and actually we are staying at the Galt House, which is up the street a few blocks, and we decided to walk down here and see what the Brown Hotel is like because we have a reservation for dinner tonight. So we've just come off the lobby, and there's a little ante room here, and it gives some pictures of the, I guess, building of the Brown Hotel, and you can see that these are very old. And as we continue, some artifacts from the Brown Hotel from way back when. And all of these pictures, I have a little plaque over here that says the Brown Hotel opened on October the 25th, 1923, only 10 months after construction began at a cost of $4 million. So that sounds like a lot of money for 1923. But over here we have some original dinnerware that was used in the restaurant of the Brown Hotel. And some more pictures. And here is a menu from the English Grill, where we have a reservation for tonight. And I notice on the menu, there is the hot brown sandwich. And over here is $1.75. I don't think it's gonna be like that on the menu tonight. We came here mainly because of the hot brown sandwich, so we'll at least take note of it, probably order it. If not, we'll have some nice food here tonight. We're in the lobby of the Brown Hotel, and we're close to the bar area, which is kind of neat, all carved and everything. There are some lions and things like that, marble topped bar. English Grill, and this is where we'll be eating tonight. So we're just going to give you a look at the place we're going to be. It might be crowded tonight, but I don't know if we'll be able to just walk around freely and take pictures. Let's see if this menu has anything to do with tonight. It has the entrees, the appetizers, and so on. I'll just give you an idea of what's on there, and I don't know if it will be the same as tonight, but what they have for appetizers, they have escargot bourguignon, baby arugula and radicchio salad, Caesar salad, Johnny corn cake salad, crab cake, seared scallops, gratiné onion soup, pottage, and then entrees, curry marinated seared tofu, pan-seared North Atlantic salmon, seared Caribbean snapper, wild mushroom dusted tuna, shrimp pasta, Angus beef 10-ounce hamburger, seared Peking duck breast, pan-roasted chicken, pan-seared Angus filet mignon of beef, grilled beef ribeye steak, spiced bourbon pork medallion, and the hot brown. I thought I was going to say, well, looks like they don't have the hot brown, but they do. It's $18. It's actually the least expensive. There's one that ties with it here, the hamburger. But it says, a Louisville tradition since 1926, roasted turkey breasts and toast points covered with sauce mornay, Parmesan cheese, baked golden brown, and finished with bacon and tomatoes. Sounds good. Found the ballroom at the Brown Hotel, and obviously they're setting up for some event. Maybe it's a wedding reception or something like that. But it's a room that back in the 20s, after the Brown Hotel opened, many as 1,200 people would gather to dance at night. And supposedly that is the reason that the hot brown sandwich was born. These people would get hungry after all of the dancing and need to be fed, and the chef came up with the perfect sandwich for them, the hot brown sandwich. I just wanted to show you that they do things in grand scale here. Large vase, and there's a matching one that's just right over there. And I don't want to get too close to these. I think they might be valuable. Come on, Shalom. It's not me. We're right here at the gift shop at the Brown Hotel, and you can see as we look along here, here is a platter. Actually, a serving dish for a hot brown, and it has a recipe on it. I don't know if it's complete, but it looks like it is. That's kind of nice. As we move over to the left, you can see a lot of Maker's Mark stuff. So a lot of the things I've shown you are just pure Kentucky. Right off the lobby of the Brown Hotel, there is a bar, or cafe, actually, that's called J. Graham's Cafe. And you can see that the table settings are like this. And right outside, there was a little pamphlet that said the hot brown. It gives some information about it. And the recipe is right there. So I will not have any problem making exactly the hot brown that comes from this hotel if that's what I decide to make from here. We're at the Brown Hotel restaurant now, and we've been given a menu to look at, and while we're looking over it, they brought us this little thing, which is lobster salad on a sort of a crouton. I didn't get an appetizer, but Rich did, and I want him to tell about it. So what'd you get?
I'll try. These are some seared sea scallops. There's a sea some peas down there in the sauce. I see some mushrooms, some kind of fancy sauce, and some curled up, I think it might be carrots, shaved and fried perhaps.
So. We have some bread that has been brought, and we have a couple pieces of each type. There's some corn muffins, they're kind of like corn sticks. We have some raisin bread, it's nice. We have some flour tortillas that are seasoned and crisped up, and we have some French baguette bread. Looks good. Well, I finally got my hot brown from the Brown Hotel, and this is what it looks like. I want to show you inside here. This is turkey right here, and more turkey right here. And on the bottom, there are toast points. There are four altogether. And we have mornay sauce around it. There are a couple of tomato halves, it looks like. And they always crisscross the bacon, which is crisped. And then on top, we have a little bit of grated Parmesan cheese and parsley to top it off. Looks wonderful. I think I'm going to enjoy it. I probably can't eat all of this, but I'll give it a try, and we'll see how it comes out. Now for Rick's, here's what he's got. He ordered shrimp and pasta. And what he has is some sauteed shrimp, and there's some flat noodles there. For the pasta, there are some slivers of, looks like some sauteed zucchini, and also it looks like some spinach and some parsley with a nice cream sauce. That's nice, thank you. This is my dessert, and it's called chocolate striptease. And I think it has devil's food cake, and then it is iced with some kind of candy icing, and it looks lovely. Rick and I are going to split this and enjoy it. So we finished our dessert, and it's the signature dessert of the Brown Hotel restaurant, this restaurant. It was made of something that was kind of like sponge cake inside. I'm not really sure what it was. And then on the bottom was something like a devil's food. It was a very thin layer. And all of this was coated with a deep, dark chocolate. And then it was flamed. And it was just wonderful. Even being so wonderful, Rick and I could not eat all of it. So we ate all we wanted. And we are so full that we're ready to leave. And we have finished our little trip to the Brown Hotel, and we're glad you came along, and we hope you enjoyed it.